So very happy Friday to you. And as I share, you know, my insights today, it's been quite an enriching, you know, journey today. I understand that while I share and present the topic for today, hoteliers, as hotel GMs, as DOSMs, we've gone through and we're experiencing unprecedented times, you know, during these, you know, last 6 months. And I really appreciate, you know, everyone that who's been sharing and who shared insights before me. We've all been talking about how the hospitality industry has changed and what's next for us and how we can reboot our initiatives and strategies to come back from the dead. You know, before I start, you know, I think what's changed apparently over the last 6 months is the traveler, whom we call the guest. And why do I call, why do I term this as new guest is, you know, while the millennial, the most connected millennial and zennial traveler, they have taken so many years to evolve. I mean, we've all been talking about it in the pre-COVID times. We've all strategized our approaches to kind of address, target them, get the most. But this is something that has really evolved just in a span of 6 months. And there's a reason behind it because, you know, we're still understanding the new guest. And let's take a look at the figures and stats which prove who the new guest could be, you know, who's got shades of consciousness, you know, consideration, and also expects a lot more from the brand these days here. So, of course, the new guest is putting health first, and the data proves it because four times there's been an increase in questions around COVID restrictions over the last 6 months. Second thing is the new guest relies more on social. It's inevitable because maybe I'm one of them. I'm the new guest as well. And you know, during these 5 to 6 months, social has been the voice. Social has been the research medium, you know, and that's where we've also seen stats where, you know, 65% of the Indian travelers prefer getting brand updates on Facebook. Of course, you know, the new guest is also demanding accountability because I think it's all about transparency during these times. They want the right information during and about the COVID lockdowns and about COVID itself, whether it's about safety, hygiene, and they're actually punishing brands on social if you know, for false or incomplete information. And there is 60% who have actually been doing it recently. Also, I think in a way, they're quite sensitive and understand that it's absolutely okay to advertise even during crisis. They also see business is important. Everybody needs business. Everybody needs ROI in their respective fields. They understand that they're absolutely fine to advertise even during these the economic impact here. Well, you know, now coming down to how do we see this new guest from the lens of general managers? I mean, we are the innkeepers here. You know, it's about owning the complete and creating the perfect experience to drive revenue. That's overall a general manager's objective. Of course, how do we see that from a GM's eyes is about following the global health and hygiene standard SOPs. That's number one to win back the guest trust and confidence. And also be transparent to this, the new segment that's coming up, the new micro segment that has evolved. That's the new guest here. So this is something, this is critical on the left side. Of course, you know, we've all kind of businesses, we've seen businesses suffer. It's not the same as it was 6 months back. So of course there is, you know, reduction on the variable cost. And what I mean by variable cost here is not like something which is needed. Variable cost is something that does not add or create the perfect experience for the new guest, which I would say I would keep aloof social media here, because we saw the stats before how social is driving engagement with this segment of traveler. And of course, I think it's also about the market has changed for everyone in the industry. So it's also looking at how do I discover the new micro segments slash markets. It could be like a leisure has even given origin to staycationer, or a leisure traveler, which has already been existent, has also given way to drivecationer, who's driving for business and leisure at the same time. So there is a lot more hybridization happening, which has come along during these 6 months, and it will continue to evolve further. It's not going to stop here. The guest is going to evolve beyond what we are seeing during the last 6 months now. Of course, all efforts to drive revenue with all these put together. And as you all know, I respect all the general managers who are on this call and who've been throughout the day. They've been a fantastic job. Of course, what we strategize is executed by our commendable front of F&B, housekeeping, and even everyone to do with the operations, because they are the delivery teams here. They're delivering, implementing that perfect experience that a GM aspires and wants to execute in the property. Which now, probably, when it comes to the new guest, of course, it's all about ensuring touchless check-in from the operations point of view. Social distancing in F&B. Of course, we see the buffets are moving out. It's a lot to do with not just the buffet, but also how do you care for that, for the guest who's coming in, the health of the guest, which also means immunity boosters in snacks, because you need to really think beyond what you were doing 6 months back. Safety in room experience. And of course, I would say the most busy part while the guest is in-house would be the concierge, which actually gives a lot more importance for a social concierge. I mean, we've seen in the past, or maybe recent past, we've heard about the Twitter as the new concierge. This will be the most important aspect in the whole journey as well, because a lot of guests will want to know if it's safe to move out. Is it safe, or which places are safe to go and eat? Or there's a lot more interaction that's going to happen beyond what it was same time last year. Of course, I think now coming to sales and marketing, I've been part of this while in hotels earlier. So while we've got the GM with the whole enabling of the experience, the executionists and the keepers of implementing that experience, now comes how do you aspire? How do you bring back the guest? How do you inspire more travelers or the new segment to come back to you or come to you? Is all about understanding the reputation, improving it, and of course, also focus on driving positive reviews from the guests who've already supported you. What's also new is also sharing, because we know that the new guest is also wanting to be updated with the right information and content. It's also what we see as user-generated and employee-generated content to win trust here. That's a big, big ask right now in that segment. And also looking at the new micro segment, because of course it's changed. How do you retarget? How do you target all of that? Plus, what plays a key role for sales and marketing is also going to be content, which means all the precautions and all the initiatives taken by your property or the hotel group needs to be communicated on the OTA brand as well as social media. And of course, we know it's a collaborative effort. I mean, it's impossible to achieve each component without everyone working together in a hotel, which means look beyond revenue is to bring scale it up and evolve it to the guest lifetime value, which actually works on three pillars, three layers. One is the service layer, which is all about exceptional service experience. We saw that in the GM's perspective. While we're creating the perfect experience to drive revenue, it's also important to have the physical experience for the guest, because the physical level comes as the moments of truth all that you've implemented from touchless check-in to a, you know, complete seamless, safe experience for the traveler is certainly going to, you know, drive satisfaction while during the stay here. The most important part is also the digital level, because that is where the new guest is active mostly. We've all kind of drifted. We've been dependent mostly on digital. We are on virtual platform now, while I think every Friday we normally land up in a pub or bar, catching up with friends and colleagues. This has become the new social as well at the same time, which means it's very, very critical to look at digital experience, being more responsive on that front here. You know, of course, when we talk about the digital experience, there are challenges because as we know, social is for everyone, which means a lot more work to be done by hotels, because there could be 2 billion followers on Instagram, and probably you might get lost in your personalized messaging or sharing. Reviews matter most now, because every review needs to be monitored and responded. That's again a critical part, because you have to be responsive. We talk about responsive digital experience here. And again, it's mostly been used to push updates, nothing beyond that. So that's something we really need to overcome to look at driving the customer lifetime value along the journey here. And why social media? I mean, we all know that. We all know the answer right now. We've experienced it ourselves. With BCB, this is our data, which actually proves a 44% increase in hotel queries on social media just between April to August in 2020 versus the same time last year. And this is completely basis the monitoring and response that we do for over 400 upscale luxury properties for over 20 plus brands worldwide. So this is our own kind of data that proves that there has been an increase on hotel queries on social media itself. There's been 40% increase even in the usage time spent, and plus 84%, I think that's a big number, are looking at social to build a sense of community. There is a lot more CSR initiatives. People would love to be associated as part of one global community, or maybe part of the local communities, and even contribute their viewpoints over there. So there's a lot bigger play for social. And of course, it could be the most profitable channel during these times to, you know, increase the engagements as well as, drive ROI. So how we do it, on BCB, we've been constantly focused on improving the guest sentiment. We've been powering over 20% improvement on the guest sentiments for over 400 properties worldwide, which are mostly upscale and luxury. Through the whole journey, I mean, when we talk about the traveler's journey, it's not easy now, because it's a lot more demanding and a bit considerate also, while they've also started to understand it is absolutely fine to advertise right now on social. So we cover this through 24/7 monitoring with response, tailored social media strategy, custom analytics, which actually help you know, anticipate, find, nurture, listen, and guide the guest or the potential guest in future. Of course, our aim is to also deliver value. We've been able to deliver over 28x ROI for all our discerning customers all this while. And we take pride in some of the best brands in the globe that we support globally. So time to rethink. I think it's still a learning phase. We're also learning a lot more. We're imbibing a lot more of our new learnings during these 6 months, because a lot of times we need to go back to basics to kind of rediscover, rethink, and reinvent what best we could come up with. After all, we're hoteliers. We're always agile and open to learnings here. Thank you so much for your time. Happy to share this presentation and consult each one of you offline as well. While I wish you a very, very happy Friday and a fantastic weekend.